In yesterday's lecture, we have seen some problems from exercise 1.1, and today also we are going to see two problems from that exercise only. And students, try to keep your video on, okay? As principal ma'am have instructed us that students must be there because she may join at any she may join at this meeting at any time, okay? So you all have to keep camera on, okay? I have sent yesterday fourth problem also, okay? So today we'll see next problem. Today's first problem: a retailer. A retailer sold a suit for rupees. एक्सरसाइज मधला से प्रणव आई थिंक 13 वाला है. मी रैंडमली घेती है जे जे डिफिकल्ट किंवा जे जे थोड़ा वेगळा टाइप चे वाटत आहेत ते. हाँ, काल सेंड केला होता ना फोर्थ वन, पाहिला नाही का अत्रेया? ओके बरं, ठीक आहे, याच्या नंतर आपण फोर्थ वन घेऊ, ठीक आहे? आफ्टर अलाउिंग 8% डिस्काउंट ऑन मार्क प्राइस एंड फर्दर 4% डिस्काउंट इफ ही मेड थर्टी 8% प्रॉफिट फाइंड द कॉस्ट प्राइस एंड मार्क प्राइस एंड ऑफ द सूट ओके. So this is our question. A retailer sold a suit for rupees 8832 after allowing 8% discount on mark price and further 4% discount. If he made 38% profit, we have to find out cost price and mark price of the suit. Okay, so let the least price means marked price only, be x. Okay, so let the least price be x rupees, we are considering it. So trade discount is equal to 8% of least price, means actual market price. List price means market price. So 8% of list price, 8 upon 100 into what is our list price into x. So 8x upon 100, this is trade discount. We know that we calculate trade discount on list price, we have seen this while seeing this trade discount. We have learned that we calculate trade discount on list price, okay? So trade discount is 8x upon 100. Now next, invoice price is equal to list price minus trade discount. List price minus trade discount, okay? So now what is list price? price X. We have considered it as X. Minus trade discount is 8X upon 100. So take LCM 100X minus 8X upon 100. This will be 100X minus 8X will be 92X upon 100. Okay. And this is invoice price. Why we need to calculate, what is the need to calculate invoice price? Because we have to calculate cash discount also. So that's why we first we need invoice price. So next, cash discount. Cash discount is equal to 4% of invoice price. So 4 upon 100 into, now what is invoice price? 92x upon 100. So this will come after cancellation and all. This will be 92x upon 2500. Okay. This is cash discount. Complete this till here, students. Complete this much part. Yes. थोड़ा पुढ़े घे ठीक है का आता प्रणव done. Done with this, students? Okay. Now next, we have to calculate net price. Now we have calculated this cash discount, but it is also in the form of 92x upon 2500. So net price is equal to, what is the formula? Invoice price, price minus cash discount. Invoice price minus cash discount. Now we know that net price, it is given 8832. What is invoice price? Invoice price is 92x upon 100 minus cash discount is, 8 second, what is invoice price? Yes, it is, and this is 92x upon 2500. Okay, 2500. So here we will take LCM. So it will be 2500. So 92x So after taking LCM, I will write directly calculation 2300x minus 92x upon 2500, and this is 8832 as it is. Okay, so 8832 is equal to 2308. This will be 2208. Sorry. X upon 2500. So 8832 into 2500 upon 2208 is equal to X. So here value of X will be 10,000 after calculations. Next is, let the cost price be, we are considering it as 100 rupees, okay? Cost price be 100 rupees. So net price is equal to cost price plus profit. So we know that net price is 8832 is equal to cost price, we are considering it as 100, and profit is 38%. So it is, we are considering it as 38. So this will be 138 and this will be 8832. So, and we know that we are considering cost price is equal to 100. Okay, so therefore cost price, we are going to do the cross multiplication. Cost price is equal to 8832 into 100 divided by 138, and this will come 6400 rupees. Okay, so here first we calculated X, value of X, by using this formula. Net price is equal to invoice price minus cash discount. So after calculating this value of X, it became 10,000. And then we considered cost price, because we have to find out cost price. So cost by price be 100 rupees. Why we are considering it as 100? Because we know that profit is in percentage and it is 38%. So we can consider it as a 38 and it is easy to calculate. That's why we are considering cost price as 100 rupees, and we know that net price is 8832. So if net price is 8832 and this whole is 138, then cost price is 100, we know that. So we cross multiply this and answer is 6400 rupees. Complete this problem, students. So now we'll take fourth problem. Okay, fourth question is also very easy actually. But will you take it? Complete this part. डन स्टूडेंट्स। Okay, now we will take fourth problem. Okay, I will write this specifically fourth. Okay, Anita is allowed 6.5% commission on the total sales made by her plus a bonus of 1/2% on the sales over ₹20,000 if her total earning amount be ₹3,400, find the sales made by her. Okay, this is our question. Okay, Anita is allowed 6.5% commission on the total sales made by her plus a bonus of 0.5%. So when we know that when we get bonus, when we do good work or extraordinary work, that at that time we get bonus. So on the sales over ₹20,000, if her total earning amount be ₹3,400, we have to find out the sales made by her. Okay, so we'll start with the solution. Let the total sales made by her be X. Her means Anita allowed 6.5% commission on the total sales. Okay, so Anita's commission on the total sales is equal to 6.5% of total sales. So 6.5% of X, because we are considering total sales be X. Okay, that means 6.5 अपॉन 100, 6.5% में 6.5 अपॉन 100 इनटू एक्स. ओके, दैट मींस इफ आई एम गोइंग टू रिमूव दिस डेसिमल, दिस विल बी 65 अपॉन 1000 इनटू एक्स. सो आफ्टर डिवाइडिंग दिस इट विल बी 13x अपॉन 200. ओके, आफ्टर जस्ट कैलकुलेटिंग. सो अनिताज कमीशन विल बी 13x अपॉन 100. ऑल्सो नेक्स्ट, ऑल्सो अनिता गेट्स हाफ परसेंट बोनस कमीशन ऑन सेल्स ऑफ रुपीज 20,000. सो सेल्स ओवर रुपीज 20,000 इज इक्वल टू टोटल सेल्स माइनस 20,000. यू नो दैट टोटल सेल्स आर एक्स एंड माइनस 20,000. ओके, कंप्लीट दिस टिल हियर स्टूडेंट्स. Done. Okay. ओके, कमीशन ऑन सेल्स ओवर रुपीज 20,000 इज इक्वल टू हाफ परसेंट ऑफ दिस सेल्स ओवर 20,000 मीन्स दिस x माइनस 20,000. ओके, हाफ परसेंट मीन्स हाफ अपॉन 100 into x minus 20,000. So this will be 1/200, because 1 upon 2 into 1/100 means 1/, this will become 1/200 into x minus 20,000. Okay, so Anita's income is equal to commission on total sales plus commission on sales, commission on sales over ₹20,000. Okay, so this will become, this will be 3,400. We know that her income is 3,400, and we have calculated this commission on total sales as 13x/200 plus, this is commission on sales over 20,000 is 1/200 into x minus 20,000. Okay, so 3,400 is equal to, so here 200 is common denominator, so 200, 13x plus, this will be as it is x minus 20,000. Okay, so 3,400 is equal to 13x plus is 14x minus 20,000 upon 200. Okay, so 3,400 into 200 is equal to 14x. I'm taking this 200 to this side, so it will be multiplication minus 20,000. So this will come 6,80,000 plus this 20,000 is equal to 14x. Now next, x is equal to, this will be 7 lakh, addition of this will be 7 lakh divided by this 40. So x is equal to 50,000. So therefore Anita sells rupees 50,000. Okay, so here we calculated this commission on sales over 20,000, and this became 1/200 into x minus 20,000. Next is Anita's income, it will be commission on total sales plus commission on sales over rupees 20,000. So we know that Anita's income is given 3,400 is equal to commission on total sales, we calculated this, this is 13x plus 200, 13x upon 200 plus this commission over sales over 20,000, this is 1/200 into x minus 20,000. So here 200 is common between this, so 200 into 13x plus this x minus 20,000. So after calculation it becomes 50,000. So Anita's sales is rupees 50,000. So complete this part, students. Done, students. Okay. Now we'll start with the discount. Okay, discount. Discount. So in that we are going to see present worth, some due, and true discount. Okay. So let us see one direct formula. Before formula, we will see what is true discount. True discount is the interest on the present worth, on the present worth at the given rate of interest for the given period. Means what is true discount? It is the interest on present worth. Present worth means it acts like principal. We know that what is principal in discount, okay, at the given rate of interest for the given period of time or just period. Okay, so next formula for present worth is equal plus true discount plus true discount sum due formula. True discount is equal to sum due. Okay, so what is sum due? Present worth plus true discount becomes sum due. Okay, so in short you can write like this: PW plus TD is equal to SD. Okay, so next, true discount that is TD is equal to PW into N into R upon 100. So where PW is principal or the bill in years R is rate of interest. Just don't write this part, just principal is present worth. Okay, present worth is principal. Okay, R is rate of interest and N is period of bill in years. Okay, and rate of interest is per annum. Per annum means annually, means yearly. Okay. Complete this part, students. Done with this? Okay, next. Students, you know that your paper pattern, it includes fill in the blanks, true or false. So you have to read that theory thoroughly, okay? Because almost this true false, fill in the blanks and all that part, almost it carries 9 to 12 marks. Okay, so you have to read the theory very carefully. Next is, next definition is drawer and drawee. Okay. A person who draws the bill, a person who draws the bill is called the drawer a person on whom the bill is drawn is called the drawee. Okay, next, date of bill and face value the date on which the bill is drawn it's called the date of bill and the amount for which the bill is drawn it's called फेस वैल्यू दैट इज एफ वी एफ डॉट वी ऑफ द बिल इट इज द sum due on the present work. Okay. Next is nominal due date. And legal due date. The date on which the period of bill expires is called the nominal due date complete this part once